Good morning. My name is Anissa Kintz, and welcome to Calling All Colors.
In the United States, a Baha'i child is leading local efforts towards racial harmony in South Carolina. Fourth grader Anissa Kintz and some of her friends organized a conference entitled Calling All Colors to teach their fellow students about unity and diversity.
You think you might know whose hands these are?
The conference was a great success and attracted the attention of the local media. Anissa told a television reporter about the aims of the conference.
We're doing something, but we're also hoping that the kids that have benefited from the conference goes and tells their friends about it, and then if those friends listen and those friends tell other friends, that it'll be sort of like a chain reaction. They'll go on and on and on, and they'll do some of the teaching for us.
In Atlanta, Georgia, the Baha'is have become a familiar sight at the annual Martin Luther King Day parade.
Fitting tribute to the day.
The Baha'i faith was the only religion mentioned in the national television broadcast of the event, which the Baha'is supported for the seventh year in a row.
The Baha'i faith and its world community. The Baha'i faith is an independent world religion with adherents in virtually every country. Its membership includes 4.5 million people living in more than 118,000 localities in over 200 countries and territories.
National Spiritual Assembly Secretary Robert Henderson was a co-grand marshal of the parade. Also present was retired member of the Universal House of Justice, Mr. David Hoffman. Dr. Henderson later spoke at a rally to an audience estimated at 100,000 people.
The Baha'i faith, in which I believe, teaches that the fundamental solution to racial and ethnic conflict rests ultimately in the common recognition of the oneness of mankind. Baha'u'llah, the prophet founder of the Baha'i faith, taught us that the well-being of mankind, its peace and security, are unattainable unless and until its unity is firmly established.
An Atlanta television station invited Mr. Hoffman for an interview.
I'm visiting all the Baha'i communities of North America, including Canada and Alaska, doing my best. They're trying to proclaim the name of Baha'u'llah to the whole of mankind, because we believe that this is a new message from God. This is the day promised in all the holy books of the world and all the religions of the world, when God will send his great messenger to establish the brotherhood of man, peace on earth. Some of Baha'u'llah's texts or writings to the kings and rulers of the world in the 19th century, like to Queen Victoria and the Pope and the heads of the religions, the earth is but one country and mankind its citizens.